Symptoms of a heart attack, I think, can vary between individuals. An individual may have the classic symptoms of chest pain or chest pressure, arm pain, a neck pain. But I think there's a good portion of people who have what we call atypical or unusual symptoms that reflect the heart attack that's ongoing. That can be some nausea, some vomiting, almost like a GI distress, a discomfort. And then I think the shortness of breath. Somebody can have shortness of breath with activity or shortness of breath at rest. I think it's interesting that a third of people don't have any symptoms at all. And we find out that they've had a heart attack later in life, and you say somewhere there's been an injury, and you never even were aware of it. So I think those are the what we think classically, but also keep in mind that, you know, this can be silent as well. When somebody's experiencing a heart attack, or a friend or a family member or even somebody in the public that you happen to witness some event, is to try to get medical help. Call 911. I mean, you need to get the people there that can help to understand, what is this? Is this the real heart attack? Is this something that has a high mortality? And the quick response is what's important. We always talk about time is muscle. It only takes a few hours for heart muscle to die, and you never get that back. So acting quickly and taking care of it is essential. So calling 911, being evaluated, making sure that you get the appropriate treatment and the appropriate management for what we worry about as a heart attack is clearly the right answer. Yep. Aspirin is one of the mainstays for treatment. It really comes down to, is the artery that gives the blood supply to the heart muscle is blocked. And that's blocked because the coagulation factors in the bloodstream occlude that vessel. And it's mostly because there's a plaque there that's developed over decades. That rupture is prothrombotic. So platelets stick to that ruptured plaque. And the way in which we can help prevent platelets from sticking to that plaque is aspirin. They are, and in fact, it's interesting that most recently we've had people survive heart attacks because of better medical management, recognition of it, and people actually make it to the hospital, survive their heart attacks, and end up in heart failure. So we've actually seen a growth of percent of patients that have heart failure as the consequence of a heart attack, where people didn't ever survive that initial insult before. It's still quite impressive that 50% of people who have their heart attack don't make it to the hospital. And there's a good chance that a good portion of those people who make it to the hospital don't live more than 30 to 90 days. So it's still a highly lethal problem, albeit we're better at it. I think it comes back to saying we need to prevent that heart attack to begin with, because if you're going to flip a coin the day it happens and you were okay yesterday, I'd want to prevent that from happening if I could.